Hey YouTube, what's going on? So we're back for another episode of the Building My Dream Jump Series. I think this is episode 18, which is crazy. And so in the last episode, if you haven't seen it, we worked on the last landing for the last big booter there, squared up the edges, guarded some of the weeds, built the steps in the side, and got it ready for when we resi it. The plan for this episode is we're gonna do a similar thing to this landing. So this one's not gonna be resi, but we get a bit closer. This one's looking a little bit rough, like the rain's washed it down a lot. It's a bit rough when the quad bike was in here, and like, I mean, you could technically ride if you wanted to, but it's just really rough. So what we want to do is like fix up this edge, get this surface all smooth again, nice and even, fix up the back and the top, make a nice case pad, go around to the other side as well. And so this one's actually had the finishing bar dragged across it in a previous episode, if you guys have been watching for a while, so it's pretty good, but just want to make it a bit tidier and tidy up this stuff here as well, make this a bit more square so this looks a bit nicer. And so that is the plan for this episode. And we side note, what's really exciting is if you look at this, like this dirt here is actually dry and almost dusty, which is crazy. We're getting really, really close into the year when it's gonna be dry enough to ride, because we're now, what is it today? The 13th of August. So spring is like only half a month away, which is really exciting. And come springtime, you know, this will keep getting dry and dry, and we'll be back into riding soon. So I'm very excited for that. And I just heard from the bike shop that my hardtail's new cranks are actually here. So super stoked on that as well. Gonna be able to ride all this again soon. But what we're gonna do, you know, hop in the time lapse, gonna start on this side, gonna scrape away the edges and stuff, get this nice and square, and then we might work on the surface and just, yeah, whole landing overhaul. So hope you guys enjoy. Let's get to the first time lapse. So we're getting well into the dig now, into the build. So what's happened so far is scraped away heaps this excess and got like a nice sort of edge going on here. There's definitely a couple holes we need to fill in. And so what I'm thinking the plan will be, have that as the main edge, and then we're flattening out this, but this will be like a second edge. And so you'll see where the riding edge is. And like, I might eventually scrape this off like the digger, so I want to do it all by hand. There's like a couple tons of dirt there, so no way, but got a good square edge there going on now. So what I need to do is, I mean, we're not going to get this as buttery as we get like the roller stuff. It just doesn't need to be, because this one's just like a big fat landing, but we'll get it a bit smoother. Then what I need to do is, there's a bit of a low point on this corner here, is get some of this clay from back here. So while scraping away to make the case pad obvious, put the clay up here, square this off, fill in some gaps. There's already a nice edge going on. Then we'll get this filled in here as well, so it's just a straight back, so it's a real obvious case pad all the way. And then with some of the excess dirt, what I'm thinking I'll do is start throwing this excess dirt over the top. And then what I think we'll do, rather than smooth this out, we'll get the excess dirt here, get this edge done, that edge. Then we'll tidy up this edge here. It should be an easier one, because there's lots of this hero dirt clay there for slapping out, which should be real nice. Then we'll do the landing surface, and then this thing will be done. So real stoked how quickly it's already coming together. So what we're going to do, we'll bring the tripod up here for maybe a bit of a different view. And we'll start filling in this hole, filling in the edges, getting this case pad done. So we'll jump back in the time lapse. Hope you guys are enjoying it. team. It's been a long bit of time lapse, but the jump's starting to look a lot better. So already we've got the sort of back edge of the case pad done. So I'm not gonna do it all the way down, shave it all off, because it's heaps of dirt, and that dirt actually holds the ramp in place pretty good and stops from sliding forward. But nice sort of edge there. I also did a light sort of slap of like the other bits that I haven't scraped away. Just look at, make it look a bit nicer, and I'm pretty stoked on how it's turned out. We'll just walk up here really quick. So already that's looking real good. It's probably harder to tell on the fisheye, and I can't really tell right now because in the GoPro it's getting darker, but getting a nice square edge there. It looks way nicer when you jump in. Like in photos, it's gonna look way better with it nice and square. And like when you ride, when the landing's nice and square, you know exactly where to look. You go around, I'm looking between here and here, know where I'm going. It makes it actually safer to ride as well. So that's an extra bonus. And yeah, it's getting a nice edge here as well. What I think I'll do tomorrow when I come back is I'll finish off that other side, get the landing bit done, and then we'll probably give this a rough slap as well so it's nice and tidy, but getting pretty stoked with how it's looking now. Got the top real quick, and just give you a quick update as well. Give that a rough slap too, and like, yeah, it's starting to look nice and square. The case pad's looking pretty good. So for tomorrow, what we'll need to do is get to the other side, square that other side nice, get this all raked, get this clay moved around, get it smooth in all the areas, maybe get a little bit of extra clay from over there to fill it in. Then we'll slap the whole thing up pretty good, tidy up this, and then she'll be done. But yeah, that's going to be it for today's efforts. It's Friday night, going to go have some dinner and stuff, get my energy back, and we'll be back here tomorrow for Saturday. So we'll see you tomorrow. Actually, we can't transition to Saturday without saying hi to Indy, because I haven't seen Indy on the channel in a while. Indy's a real good girl. Hey, girl. Hey. Hey. Yeah. Say hi, Indy. Down. Yeah, who's a good girl? Love dog content on this channel. So you're a good girl, aren't you, Indy? Hey? Mean. We'll see you tomorrow. Sweet, guys. End of day two of working on this landing. And so it's Saturday morning now. And man, it has rained a lot overnight. Like, there is no puddles here last night at the bottom of the ramp. And like, it's almost over my foot deep. See how all the water's run down here, and like, yeah, puddles there, jump soaking wet, and I guess it just got, winter's just showing me, you know, that's not quite over yet, and because I said at the start of the video, it's almost dry enough to ride, now, like, it's definitely not, but this is how she goes in winter and spring. And all honesty, like, having it this wet is perfect for digging. And so what we're going to do now, we're going to jump straight back to the time lapse. We're going to work on this edge here, get this edge on this side, I'll squirt off at the other edge, get it nice and smooth, then we'll look into raking the landing part, getting that smooth as well, then we'll give it all a nice square up again. So we'll get back to the time lapse now. Man, that was a lot of dirt to move, a lot of side to slap up, and a lot of stuff to square up. But man, this is looking good now. So much better than it used to look. And so instead of digging all the way down, again, I made this little platform here because it's just easier moving all that dirt by hand. Eventually might scrape it with the digger or something. It also has the added benefit, you can stand up there for photos. But it's all squared up on that edge, on the back, on the other side. So what we need to do now is this landing here, the actual bit we ride on, finally getting to the part we actually ride on. Need to rake all this dirt evenly across here and then slap it in. It's gonna be a little bit tricky because, I mean, if you haven't noticed in the time lapse, like, if you look at this, it is just super slippery. Like, it is so muddy, which is really good for shaping the clay, but definitely is gonna make it interesting when I'm walking up this landing, because it's just It's reasonably steep, reasonably high, but gonna get it done, and the sun's out, so like once you got the slat though, it's gonna harden up real nice. You can already see on this other edge it's quite hard. So what I'll do is rake this, slap this in, then to finish up we'll probably give this side one last once over we haven't slapped in, like just here on that platform, then it'll be pretty much done. But real stuck with the processing, gonna be so good when that one's square and this one's square. It's gonna look so much better for photos and it's way tidier. So we'll jump back into this next time lapse into this massive slap draw. Let's get it done. Sweet guys, after a mammoth effort and heaps of slip and slide on this landing, she is done and she is all slapped up. It's not perfectly buttery, but just like walking up this, you're just constantly sliding, as you would have seen the time lapse, but I'm pretty happy with it. Like, it's probably the biggest landing I've ever slapped up before, and it's got a nice edge here, then a nice wee platform, nice case pad on top, same like transition all the way down, nice and smooth. Like, there's a bit more winter, lesser rain, sun, and rain and sun on this. We'll make this like rock hard and a rock even better than it did before. Now this side's got like a pretty nice edge as well. Pretty stoked with how square it looks. Sort of slapped in this stuff here a little bit. We might come back to this. I'm just tired and sort of a bit over it, so I'm gonna do that bit right now. If we walk up to the back side of the jump, you can see those nice edges there. It's looking real good. We'll go right behind the ramp to show you guys. Ooh. So if you see it, I might have to back up more. You know, oh, I can see how slippery it is. Yeah, if you look at that, you can see like square edge, square edge, square on top. You know exactly where you're heading. It looks so much better for like photos and stuff, and just ride safer, you know where to aim. We'll give you a look from over this edge as well. This is where I think it looks the best. Oh man, look at that sun coming out. That is mean. And check that out. Looks so, so good. Well stoked on that. So what we're gonna do, because the sun's out, I forgot to do any before photos, but we'll try and put together some before and after now to show you guys how much work's been done on this. Hopefully that before and after turned out pretty good. I actually don't know how it looks yet because I haven't edited, and I've just been forgetting to do the before shots in the last two videos, so I'll make sure in the next digging video I do a before shot. But overall, really stoked on how this has turned out. Like, it's gonna look so much better in photos now. It's gonna ride so much better. It's gonna be sick for summer, and like, it probably won't need done again at all either. And like, if you look at that backdrop, just imagine like some big tricks on here at that backdrop. It's gonna be awesome. So well stoked on that. What I'm thinking the plan for the next digging video will be is we'll either slap up the berm and fix the berm up, because the berm needs to be done when it's wet so it really packs and hard and sets hard. Or we'll go into working on one of the jumps over the fence and get those ready to go, because if the weather improves, like today obviously cloudy as it's gonna rain some more, and it could even potentially snow. But if the weather improves, you know, like these jumps will probably be rideable in the next month, which is really exciting. But like when you look at that now, shall I show you how wet it is? There is a massive puddle right in front of the long and low lips. They're still a ways off, but you know, if we get a good couple of dry weeks, we might be able to ride. So we're gonna slowly work on fixing these things up. And yeah, I think we probably will look at fixing these things up next, because then we'll be able to ride like from that jump in this set anyway, as soon as it's dry. Then probably work on the resi and just work on everything. So heaps more digging videos to go, but that's gonna be the end of this one. So if you guys have enjoyed this, I'd really appreciate if you gave the video a like. It helps me out heaps. Share the video around with anyone you think might enjoy this video, enjoy the digging. Leave a comment what your favorite part of the video was, what you're looking forward to next, or maybe like what trick you think would look sick on this jump. And subscribe if you're new. Cheers for watching, team. We'll see you in the next one.